Hi guys, it's Amy. So off the tee box, there might be people watching you, like a big gallery, or it may be a very important hole. So today I'm gonna show you how to minimize mistakes in a pressure situation like that and rip it down the middle. So when you're under pressure, what happens is your shoulders get tense. When your shoulders get tense, what happens is with the driver, you end up kind of pulling through the ball. So when you pull through the ball, what happens is you swipe across it a little bit and you're going to not be able to hit it square or solid and gonna put slight side spin on it. And it's going to obviously either slice or hook. So with the driver, you can't pull through. You have to either throw through or push through. I'm sure you've heard of either one. So there are two different reasons why you're not able to throw through. So the first reason is when you're under pressure, you get quick, right? So sometimes you don't complete your backswing. So when you don't complete your backswing, there is not enough turn in the backswing. So on the way down, there isn't enough space for you to turn through. That means the power is going to be that much weaker. So subconsciously, your body is going to try and make up that power by pulling through with your arm strength. So it's gonna look less turn and pull through for power. We want to make sure we turn all the way, so at least the back is facing the target. That's the minimum amount of turn I want from you guys. Back to the target. That way, you're not going to even think about pulling through because you have enough power through the ball. Second reason why you pull through is because either you don't know what it feels like to throw at the ball, or you know how to, but you're just not used to it. So I have one great drill for you guys to fix both of them at the same time. I kind of made this up, but most of my students love this drill because it gets them to feel what the actual proper golf swing is supposed to feel like. So try this with me. Basically, you're going to grip the club upside down with the left hand on first. And you're going to use the left arm and the club to rotate your torso 90 degrees back. So you're going to turn back so the back is facing the target. It's left hand only in the backswing, so it's really hard to go all the way up. So we'll just go halfway up, okay? So when you do this rotation with the body, make sure you have a 90 degree turn. Just be careful you don't just lift it up with your arms like this, left arm like this, and you don't turn. That's wrong. So make sure you rotate back, and then you're gonna switch hands here. Once you switch hands, I want you to go to your actual top position, and then you're gonna make a swoosh sound in front of the golf ball. So it should look, hear that sound right there? So instead of kind of making the swish behind the golf ball, it should be in front of the golf ball so you feel that throwing sensation. So let's try this together. So left arm makes your torso turn. You're gonna take your time and switch, and you're gonna swoosh. If you have a lot of tension in your right shoulder when you swoosh, you're not gonna hear the sound as loud. So it's actually really going to make your core do all the work and relax your shoulder like this. You're gonna feel it in the core for sure. So one more time, left hand back, relax the right shoulder, swoosh through. So if you're used to that, let's go ahead and hit the ball. Basically, you're gonna hit it with both hands on the club because I don't want you to hurt your shoulder. But you're still going to pretend like you're going left hand rotate, right hand swoosh, okay? Let's try. I threw through that pretty good. So this drill is really going to help you get in the rhythm so you turn and throw all in one motion instead of breaking it all down. You know how important rhythm is, right? So next time you're under pressure off the tee, just remember the turn and swoosh. You can even do this on the golf course if you don't feel yourself turning enough or swooshing enough. And just make sure turn, swoosh. So it goes one, two. Next time, really calm yourself down. Get rid of the slice. Get rid of the tense shoulders. and rip it down the middle. I hope you're able to follow along. If you have any questions, please come visit me on facebook.com/golfwithamy. Thank you and see you next time.